Hello friends, welcome to free grammar lessons. In this video, we will learn the basics of subject-verb agreement. Before understanding subject-verb agreement, we will understand what is subject and verb in the sentence and how to identify subject and verb in any sentence. Then we will understand what exactly is subject-verb agreement and basic rule surrounding it. So without a further go, let's get started. So what is a subject in the sentence? The subject of a sentence is the person, place, thing or idea that is doing or being something. And what is a verb in the sentence? It is the action performed by the subject or state of being. Let's understand it with an example. Ajay plays cricket regularly. Now, to identify the subject, ask here who is performing the action of playing. It is Ajay. So, Ajay is the subject here. And to identify the verb, ask the question what subject is performing. It is playing. So, it is the verb in this case. This way, we can identify the subject and verb in the sentence asking these questions. Now, based on point of view, subject may be in first person, second person or third person. In first person, we have I and we. In second person, we have you. And in third person, we have he, she, it, they. And based on count, subject may be singular or plural. These all things we have discussed in detail in our Parts of Speech video series. I will provide you the link in the description in case you need it. Please go through those videos, you will get the revision. Now, let's understand the main topic of today. What is subject-verb agreement? For making a sentence grammatically correct, a verb must agree with its subject in number. That is to say, in any sentence, singular subject must have singular verb and plural subject must have plural verb. This is the most general rule. So again, I will repeat. Singular subject must have singular verb and plural subject must have plural verb. Please note, this statement holds true only when subject is in third person. Now, let's look into examples to make things clear. Let's look into example where subject is singular. That monkey eats banana. Here, subject is monkey, which is singular. So, verb will also be singular. In this case, it is eats. Let's look into one more example. This car goes fast. Here, the subject is car, which is singular. Verb will also be singular. In this case, it is goes. Now, let's look into same examples where subject is plural. Those monkeys eat bananas. Here, subject is monkeys, which is plural in form. So, verb will also be plural in form. So, in this case, we used eat. Let's look into the next example. These cars go fast. Here, the subject is cars, which is plural in form. So, verb will also be in plural form. So, please remember this rule. The rule is that singular subject has singular verb and plural subject has plural verb. Please note, we have seen examples only where the third person is used. Now, let's look into examples where subject is not in third person. I read newspaper regularly. Here, I is singular. But verb read is in plural form. Let's look into one more example. We read newspaper regularly. Here, we is in plural form and verb read is also in plural form. So, in case of first and second person, there is no rule of singular subject, singular verb and plural subject must have plural verb. Please remember this concept also. There are some important rules related to subject-verb agreement. Those rules we will discuss in next video. Let's quickly revise what we learned in this lesson. Firstly, we understood what is subject and verb in a sentence. Then, we understood how to identify subject and verb in any sentence. Then, we understood what is subject-verb agreement. Finally, we went through some of the examples of subject-verb agreement's general rule. So that's all in this video. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any questions or suggestions, please write in the comment section. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. Do share the video so others can learn, and do subscribe to this channel and also press the bell icon to get regular updates about the course. You guys are best at your studies. All the best for your upcoming exams. We will meet in the next video soon. Till then, goodbye.